Hello, listeners.
Hey, viewers.
You know, we've covered a lot of themes over the last few weeks of Let's Drown Out, like shooting people and blowing people up and punching them with our shirts off.
Oh, yeah.
And whatever the fuck
the best
was,
kind of punching.
And whatever the fuck was going on in Blue Stinger. But this week, I thought it was high time we did something constructive. That's why you're all going to enjoy watching me tinker with my Minecraft project for the next hour.
There it is. Yahtzee's really committed to the boring part of the boring aspect of the drownouts.
Minecraft is not boring. Minecraft is great.
I'm teasing. I actually really enjoy it, even though I don't play it. I don't really, you know, I don't personally gain enjoyment from playing it, but I do understand and acknowledge the kind of fun that it is.
I do tend to get absorbed by it. We will illustrate that shortly, because this isn't my actual base. This is my first base. I just still keep some things in here. My actual base is out there.
This is on a group server, isn't it?
Yep.
So there's other people that we might run into, looking forward to.
We've got a portal here that leads to someone else's area, because we're using the Feed to Beast launcher with the Direwolf 20 expansions, which is just a sort of grab bag of Minecraft mods with additional features. Let's see who gets that joke.
I mean, as much as kind of that was highlighted in the extreme negative in Rapture, I really do sort of subscribe to that.
I'm sure you do, Mr. Ayn Rand, the man.
I am not a Randian.
I think this might be a misquote, though. I think it's supposed to be no gods or kings, only man. Yeah. Ah, you bastard.
Hey, something exciting's happening.
You're not supposed to be here.
Dude, he's hurting you. You better, like, kill him.
You are a parasite.
Yes,
I think
get out of my Galtian wonderland.
I think it's supposed to be no gods or kings, only man.
Yeah, it is.
Only men kind of sound like something else. Now I'm imagining a utopian city populated entirely by hunky blokes.
No chicks or shit, only dudes.
With bow ties and no shirts.
I imagine that'd be like a good thing for like gay bros, like just total like dude bro paradise.
Well, and here's my little entrance hall. Designed to look a bit catacombsy.
I can't help but have, like, I appreciate this, but I kind of go, oh, isn't that quaint? Like, that's just kind of how I view this.
And here's my little wheat garden, which makes bread. Where did this carrot?
It sure does.
Where did this carrot come from? Was that zombie holding
a carrot? Yeah, the zombie
had
a carrot.
I guess his zombie mum gave him that so he'd have some vitamins.
If I am bit in the zombie apocalypse, I'm spending my last remaining human moments just loading up my pockets with weird assorted shit. So whoever, like, scavenges from me is just, why the fuck was he carrying 8 pacifiers?
You know,
did he get these before or after?
You know, that sounds like my experiences with DayZ.
Yeah. That would be a fun thing. I'm trying to get around to getting into DayZ, but it's just sort of...
This is my bedroom. I'll show you where I found this block later. That's an interesting story.
Looks like Yahtzee's actual enchantment under the sea themed bedroom.
What have I got in here? Oh, yes.
Enchantment under the me.
Someone gave me a jetpack and some scuba gear to help me build this thing. There's
is
a whole
place leaking? Is it meant to leak?
Some blocks do that when there's water directly above them. Glass blocks don't.
Man, shit's changed from the last time I played this.
Yeah, it's come a ways. Now, our project for today is I'm going to knock through here and then get start work on my giant underwater arboretum. Does that sound like a slice of fried gold?
Sounds incredibly fun to watch.
I'm sure it will be.
You're wearing a special helmet.
You can appreciate some culture for once.
No, see, it's the thing, like, I appreciate Lego. I can't do Lego. Because I'm insane. I need structure. I need to be told what to do. Otherwise, it's just like sitting down and going, the universe, enjoy it. And I'm just like, what am I supposed to do now? Like, I kind of need that. I appreciate that you can enjoy this, but it's just not.
Yes, at heart, you're just a mealy-mouthed little instruction follower, aren't you?
No, it's one of those things where it's like, you know what you want out of this. You can go in and go, I want to build an underwater palace. Yes. I want everything that can and will ever be.
I want to build an objectivist utopia filled with hunky Chippendales.
This is turning into Anthem. Are you living in a world where the word I doesn't exist? That's a really terrible book, and that's like one of Ayn Rand's better ones, too.
Now, one of the interesting properties of ladders in Minecraft is that if there's one on a block, it will not allow water to pass, which is very handy if you're doing something like this.
Huh.
Minecraft water is a bit wacky. And like a lot of features in Minecraft, this is probably just a bug that hasn't been cleared up yet.
Nah, they'll fix that. Replace it with, like, some sort of gravity wall so you can still do construction like this.
I'm picturing lines from Bioshock being delivered from the perspective of the Hunky Men's manifesto. A man chooses to bench press. A slave spots me for a bit, if you wouldn't mind.
Hey, the spotter is not a slave. They are an important part of the workout process. I suppose you could use a slave for a spotter. But I don't know. I'd kind of want... Well, yes. You need a spotter you trust. Not someone who kind of secretly wants you to die.
Well, that's obviously not a well-broken slave then, is it?
I suppose it depends on what kind of slavery you're going with. Kind of go the ancient style where, they're kind of...
I'm thinking hunky man slavery.
Fair
enough. Where I have a hunky man who fans me with leaves and stuff. Now, the trouble with building on the ocean floor is it gets really sodding dark.
I love the divide between the start and the end of that sentence. my fellow engineers will understand when I say the building on the ocean floor, it's a bit dark.
Yeah, it tends to be.
I remember I used to live with this guy who fancied himself a DJ, and, like, don't get me wrong, like, had all the equipment and shit, he just, wasn't very good. He was kind of like the glorified iPod style of DJ. I used to give him shit because DJ Hero had come out recently and he was having some big serious talk with someone, and I decided to interject deliberately, completely ignorantly, just to annoy him a little bit, and then, came out with the line like, I play DJ Hero on Extra Hard. I think I know a little something about DJing. And he knew I was doing that just to, it was a dumb thing just to fucking fuck with him a little bit, but it still set him off.
I'm going to swap out with my scuba helmet. I got a jetpack powered by a solar helmet, but that shit does not...
So that's a solar helmet.
It really does not take a short time to charge these things.
Fuck, I am legitimately really impressed with all the stuff that's gone into it now. There wasn't none of this shit when I was playing it. Although, admittedly, weirdly, one of my favorite... Because I spoke about this once before on one of the old records we did, but one of my absolutely most exciting and enjoyable video game moments was in Minecraft.
Yes, it tends to have those moments. That's what I like about it.
Well, I think it's the difference between allowing a game that allows awesome moments to happen, like a bit with Just Cause 2 when the missile came by.
Oh, yes.
Like, that wasn't a scripted event, and so it was so much better. You're just like, holy shit, that almost happened.
I've often railed about.
Yeah, yes. And now the problem is they want to control when the cool happens so they can force it, and then it just becomes less special.
Yes.
But, like, yeah, because a friend of mine had started, like, a little server and was really nagging at me to get into this. And I'm like, all right, well, I'll have a look. And we started, like, out on our little space like you normally do, sort of just walking around, building our little huts so we don't get, murdered by horrible nightmare creatures.
Mm.
And I got killed because the laptop I was playing it on was, I think, made out of cheese. And it couldn't even run Minecraft without fucking, stuttering. And I got killed. So then I figure I'm going to respawn at the place we originally spawned. And I didn't. I respawned in a fucking tropical jungle and had no idea even where the house was or even if I could fucking get to it. So I got my friend to look at the sunset, and then I looked at the sunset so I could go, okay, that's the direction I have to go. And then just went running hell for leather. It was just like, just run. I think I might be able to make this if I just run.
I'm pretty sure you told this story on this series once.
It wasn't this series.
Is this the one where you put the Indiana Jones theme on your iPod?
And you put the Indiana Jones theme on and just sprint. And I, like, heart in my fucking, like, mouth. It was so much fucking fun. I don't think any other game's quite has been ever as exciting as that. Like, just Indiana Jones run, trying to get back to...
Anything you can do to get rid of water spawning blocks is to replace them with something.
Oh, so the water was just going to keep appearing even though you'd walled it off.
Yeah, that's the trouble with water spawn blocks.
Huh. That'd be more fun if reality had shit like that.
Well, yes.
What's that? So there's a water spawn block.
There's a lot of things.
I call a cloud that now. Oh, look, it's water spawn block.
Anyway, this is probably going to get boring, so we should probably start on a topic.
Probably.
As I work on my little tunnel.
Okay, your first topic is Disney flexing.
Yes, Disney have been acting a bit weird lately. It's all this intellectual property they've got, it's going to their heads.
They have a frightening amount of stuff now.
I think I have a list of things they've done written down there.
Yeah, Deadpool's been taken off of all digital services, so it's not on Steam anymore, it's not on PSN.
Seems to apply to a lot of other Activision-made Marvel properties, though strangely not this. I think it was the Amazing Spider-Man movie game was not included.
I haven't played that. Does that have open web-slinging?
It's pretty dire. It's open world, but it's not web-slinging like Spider-Man 2 was web-slinging.
Then I don't fucking care. Like, when will they let Spider-Man game makers learn that that was just... That's copy that. Just fucking do that again.
In fact, the problem with the Amazing Spider-Man was that there was literally a control where you just point at where you wanted to go and press a button.
And he'd web-swing over there.
Yeah, and he'd just go there.
Oh, that completely understands the fun of that video game, you fucking morons.
That's what I liked about Spider-Man 2 on the...
GameCube or PS2.
Yes, on that particular generation. It's because you... Basically, how fast you swung was dependent on... how well you'd timed and angled it.
Yeah, it was fucking amazingly good.
So you treated it like an extreme sports game, like a Tony Hawk or something. That's why I liked it.
You couldn't web swing onto something if it wasn't there, and that made it like they had some really cool puzzles where you had to find out a way of getting over to an island and stuff. Like, I mean, you know, it was GameCube era, so the graphics were kind of like minimal. I downloaded a fucking ISO of it recently, and getting that to run's a chore.
Now, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to dig under the ocean bed, and we're going to dig out the space we need under the water. Before we actually start working on the glass dome at the top,
which
will be the complicated part on account of all the water that's all over the place.
But yeah, so Disney's basically seems to be pulling in its Marvel properties, because they took Capcom's, you know, Marvel versus Capcom is gone from all digital services, and Capcom aren't allowed to make modifications or changes now to the fight system because that counts as new material.
They haven't renewed the contract with Capcom, have they, that Marvel has?
No. So, much like Marvel vs. Capcom 2, I look forward to playing Marvel vs. Capcom 3 for a decade. That'll be nice.
Yep.
A decade of bullshit.
But why are Disney doing all this?
Yeah,
is it because they're just monsters, as we've always suspected?
Something's brewing.
There's some rumors abound. Like, maybe they want to start their own digital download service, start their own... Media empire based around all of that.
It's not a small, like, I mean, when you tally up Marvel and Star Wars in general, like what you can do.
Because, of course,
with it.
Disney has Star Wars now. Probably going to put it in Kingdom Hearts or something.
Good.
That's exactly the kind of shit they'd pull.
Yeah. Honestly, I'm not too bothered by that. Like, I don't mind provided they do something, you know, do something with it. And that's what I like about Disney at the moment is, I mean, yeah, they're fucking, like, eating all this shit, but they're also producing. I have no doubt in my mind that the fucking...
Well, George Lucas was producing the prequel trilogy.
Yeah, but Disney have been doing better. Like, they've...
It was a weird case, that, wasn't it? That was one of the first cases I've seen of an intellectual property being taken away from its original creator and everyone going, thank fucking God,
yeah. Like that. No, seriously. And you know what? They're going to start releasing movies in the Star Wars universe, and I bet they're going to be fucking better. At the very least, they'll be better than the fucking prequels.
Well, few things could not be.
I know, but that's what I mean. And that's the way they've been going with the Marvel movies, like where they just go, all right, well, instead of doing a relentlessly market-researched corporate build, and I say corporate, you're going
to die. Squiddies can't hurt you.
Oh.
But they can be annoying for someone making an underwater biodome complex.
Fucking squid. I thought the water was going to start flooding in or something.
Nah.
Oh, the ladders are in the way.
Yeah,
I forgot.
That's why I put the ladders there.
You got magic ladders.
Yeah, everyone in Minecraft has magic ladders.
I'm not down with all the hip kids on the Minecraft bits and bobs.
You should play more Minecraft.
Nope. I already have enough time sync games. I sit and play King of Fighters 13, counting frames, and do the same for Street Fighter AE. So I have my weird anal video game corners that I'm not adding to.
I think we all have our weird anal corners. at least that's
corners.
What my last prison bunkmate found out.
Yeah, your ass has corners.
Yeah.
It's fascinating. It's like a Lego block.
It takes a lot of exercise to get those going. But I'm not terribly worried about what's going on with Marvel or Star Wars. Neither property is one I'm particularly nuts about.
Well, I am a big fan of the Marvel Universe, a big fan of what they've been doing with the movies. And I think, again, like, what they've been doing is...
Rather than doing...
Because you hear about some of the rumors going around about what Iron Man was originally going to be, and it's like, it was going to have, like, fucking... What's that automaton? Tom Cruise. It was going to have, like, Tom Cruise in it. And that's the biggest problem with, like, when Warner Brothers releases a movie that doesn't have Batman in it, usually, it's... You know what I mean? It's like a movie made by committee. So there's no risk-taking, there's no sense of originality, there's no... It's such a safe film that it becomes asinine and boring. And Marvel's taking fucking risks, and they've been paying off. Like, for Guardians of the Galaxy, they got James Gunn, who made Slither and The Specials, and is a great weird...
Wasn't James Gunn the guy who made Lollipop Chainsaw?
He had input into the plot of that, which that showed.
That was a weird one.
I liked Lollipop Chainsaw. The gameplay is, I think, one of Suda 5-1's probably weakest fucking elements at this point.
I've always found the trouble with Suda games lately is it's hard to tell exactly how much involvement he has in them.
I really want him to make a wrestling game again. I think he needs to get back to his roots. Just make a wrestling game and have some fun.
Well, that would appease you.
Yes, it would. I also love professional wrestling. But yeah, like, Marvel are taking risks, and Disney are letting them. That's the thing. Disney are just going, all right, just go do this thing, and we'll see what happens. And that's impressive from a vast corporate fucking oligarchic point of view. Like, they're actually allowing creativity to occur, which is... I know, it's fucking crazy. Who'd have fucking thunk it?
Oh, that Disney of all people.
Yeah! And so I'm sitting and looking at what they're going to be doing with, you know, we barely know anything yet. I think there's a...
Well, you know, I always...
A Boba Fett movie in the works. And you know what? I bet it's going to be at the very least fucking watchable.
Why do people like Boba Fett? He's just a twat with a bucket on his head.
He didn't say anything and he killed people, which automatically makes him the coolest thing in the world.
I mean, people in glass houses, I know, looking at my hat there. Actually, I'm literally a glass house, so that worked pretty well.
Yeah, there's a lot of layers to that particular joke.
I know. It's like I have a really sophisticated, like, Swiftian wit in my head somewhere that I'm occasionally permitted to access.
Just a bunch of writers working in the back of your brain.
But, you know what always worries me is...
spiders.
The possibility... Well, that
giant
as well.
Giant spiders.
But the possibility of someone monopolizing something.
Yeah, that's a concern too, because... And a dictatorship's fantastic when your dictator is lovely.
Exactly. The benevolent dictatorship might be a solid option in some cases, but it's only as lasts as long as the dictator.
Yeah. I mean, there is that, you know, obvious vulnerability, and I am expecting it to go to shit, because it just will.
Well, that's just
the
flow
of
things, isn't it?
Yeah.
You expect things to go to shit.
It's just, well, I mean, not immediately, but it, you know, odds are, you know, they'll start releasing weaker films, they'll panic, they'll want to replicate the old success, and they'll start doing that by, you know, producing sort of derivative boring works.
Man, there's free minerals abound down here.
Free minerals! I mean, that's probably going to happen, but, I mean, at the moment, I think it's remarkably impressive, and again, who'd have thought fucking Disney would be the fucking bastions of any level of creativity?
I guess. Hey. Disney have been up and down, haven't they?
Yeah, but I think at the moment they're on a bit of a remarkable roll at the moment.
They've always gone through phases. I mean, they ruled the roost with like Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs back in the day, but then there was this really prolonged period that only ended when The Little Mermaid came out, when they were just kind of shit.
And then they bought Pixar, and
they're producing shit like The Rescuers.
Hey!
Well, no one watched that.
Fuck you! All right, I like The Rescuers.
All right, you watched it.
Yeah.
Hush my mouth, but I don't think I've ever said a truer statement, but we should not judge all of the human race by you.
shouldn't do it by anyone. But I enjoy The Rescuers. Disney, like, I don't know. It's, again, it's impressive because they could so easily just do what has always been done. And instead, they are actually taking some legitimate sort of risky moves with properties, which is paying off and good for them, and I hope they continue.
You are so fond of the word legitimate.
Well, because there's a big difference between...
I have to edit these videos. It's like a drinking game with you.
Yeah, well, everyone has verbal tics. Like, that's just a thing. Like, I repeat words an awful lot. Like, I do it when I write, too. It drives me insane, because I have to go back through and, like, cut out, like, just. I say just, like, 1,000 fucking times.
It's true. Like, you also say again a lot when you're about to say something that you've probably reiterated too much.
Yeah, see, it's literally a verbal tic. Like, everyone has these. You can, if you start listening to them with your friends, you can sort of pick them.
And since I, like, edit these videos, I've picked up on a few of mine as well.
Mm.
Like, saying that things are crazy.
I just, it's those, your brain has load times.
Green now.
So your voice just fills it with a loading word. And that's where you get your ums and your ahs. Apparently they're culturally variable. Like, different cultures will have different versions of um and ah.
Apparently politicians are trained to, when they feel the urge to say um and ah, to say instead something like look or listen or something dynamic, you know.
Oi!
Just let me say this.
You shit cunts.
Just let me say this. That's one.
But I say legitimately because there's always that big difference between what's said and what's actually being done.
More iron. Shit. I fucking love
iron. Is that iron?
Yeah, I love my iron
ore.
Looks
like cracker.
You can make more pickaxes with it. Except my inventory's getting full pretty routinely at this point.
Is this one of those... I hear there's like adventure maps that they make with this where there's a dragon and purpose and stuff.
Yeah, well, you can create a teleporter to the nether, which will take you to another world where there's lots more monsters and shit, and there's special like materials that you can that certain recipes call for, certain very exotic ones.
Cool.
And there's a final dungeon sort of terrain called the end, where you have to fight the ender dragon. That's like the best item in the game after you kill that one of those.
I want to see someone try and make RNA in Minecraft.
Yeah, well, I always think, you know, all that adventure stuff is missing the point a bit. How wide am I making this biodome?
I don't know. It's not my underground arboretum.
Well, here's the starting wall. This is 6x4.
What's the green thing?
I don't know. I don't care either. That's fine.
Dude,
out.
How can you...
Well, my inventory's full, so I can't pick it up. I think it's just like, you know, emerald or something.
It's just some fucking emerald.
Yeah, what are you going to do with emerald, man?
Give it to someone...
Where were we? Sure, oh, yes, Disney sort of command a pretty large percentage of popular culture at this point, don't they? Marvel and Star Wars.
And I mean, they keep... Because they also keep renewing their copyrights on things that should have gone out of copyright a long time ago. And I'm kind of on the fence about whether that's a good or a bad thing. Because on the one hand, you know, it would be nice for some of these things to enter into the public domain and have access to more creative minds. But on the other hand, it's also nice to have the canon of something not... open to the madness that, you know, the greater human population will bring to it.
I think Marvel, well, Disney also are pretty evil by default. I mean, these are the ones who are continually, like, shifting public domain laws so that Mickey Mouse is always copyrighted.
I think that's what I just said.
Yes, well...
You're too busy hitting rocks.
Yes, I'm busy punching these rocks.
With a pickaxe. But is that such a bad thing? Because I don't want... Honestly, the canon of some of these fucking superheroes open to just idiots.
But then again, the public domain is where a lot of properties thrive. Look at Sherlock Holmes.
Yeah, no, I mean, like I said, I'm not absolutely one way or the other, and I probably do favor, like, if, you know, if I break it down and deconstruct it, I probably do favor things, you know, creeping out into the open domain a little bit.
I would quite like to live in a world where Batman is public domain. Although he practically is these days. All the, like, fan stuff and works and that. Now, I'm trying to create more books so I can make bookshelves, which so far I have that many of.
So, wait, you need...
I want to make a library down here at
you
some
make
point.
Books, you make bookshelves out of books?
Yes, and wood.
What? Don't play this goddamn thing. I don't know how shit works.
Well, you should. It's good.
I'm not... No.
Trouble is, to make books, I need leather.
Of course.
And to get leather, I have to go and murder cows. So we might have to go on a cow murdering jamboree at some point.
You can't breed cows?
Well, you can, but I can't be arsed.
All right.
So I'll just go and murder them instead. Yeah, it's a much better plan.
Yeah. Just wander into somebody else's farm and just...
Well, they occur naturally in the wild a lot.
Yeah. Yeah.
Actually, I've got all this iron ore. Might as well smelt it.
What's all that crazy-ass shit going on the right there when you open up that thing?
The what?
All that stuff on the right.
Well, that's just like... This is something that this mod has. It's just a list of all the blocks and stuff.
Okay.
So if I wanted to see how you make TNT, it will tell
me. Oh, all right. So it's a guide. Okay.
Yes.
I wish I had that when I was playing. Granted, cumulatively played this game about, like, you know, 10 hours.
See, I planted some sugar cane so I could make paper out of it, but you just cannot give this shit away. It grows like bacteria.
Good. Well, isn't that good? Then you got paper. And you should start a... dairy or a cow farm or whatever, like an underwater dairy. That'd be amazing.
I don't want to keep cows under here. It seems cruel. Yes, I know where you got what you're going to say.
Good.
But, you know, let's allow let cows them, to have, them. Like, a wild life in the jungle, and then...
Sneak up on them and just... And
kill them at the end of it. I don't see any problem with that.
Beat them with a stick.
I think this is 14 cubes along, so this is where we need to be.
See, this is like Lego to me. It's like, I get it, I just can't. My brain just doesn't seem to respond well to it.
You know, I've been noticing that a lot in what you say. You tend to try to assuage responsibility by claiming biological issues.
No. I mean, it's a combination of things. Like, I can control it, I can change it, but it's also, like, in terms of, like, when you're controlling yourself, you have to apply energy. And it's up to you how much energy you want to apply to certain things. And particularly, like, this is a weird, like, that obsessive, it's that absolutism of me where...
You know, I have to admit, since I started playing Minecraft, I've looked back in fresh light on my dad's model railroad habits. Because it interested him and no one else. But I'm kind of ashamed to admit, I kind of have the same thing with Minecraft.
It's fun. Like,
yeah, I like it.
You know. I accept the fun of it. I'm just not good at it, and it's just more in it. You know, I don't see the value. You know, why commit energy to fixing that when it's not really a problem?
I want to make a fun place.
Fun times. You should be one of those people that builds like working calculators out of Minecraft blocks or something.
No, that's a bit much.
Every time I see something like that, I thank God that Minecraft has taken another possible serial killer out of the mix.
I think it is strange though, because you know I like the sense of achievement from making things in Minecraft, but I actually have achievements in real life as
well.
Yeah,
real, like, stuff.
I've had books published. That's a big one.
I don't know, man. Like,
well, a book published, not self-published.
Yeah. I once read a self-help book that was predicated on the idea that the movie The Matrix was a factual documentary. It was depressing. Just the... just sad. It was just really fucking sad. Because you can tell someone's going to buy that and be really excited and finally happy. And they shouldn't be. And it's just heartbreaking. And that was a book that someone published on paper and put into a bookstore.
I think we would all be happier if we did know we all lived in The Matrix.
Really? I don't know. I don't think it matters.
Well, you know, it's a sort of absolution of responsibility, isn't it?
Well, see, the way I see...
And it's also a confirmation of the fact that there is some controlling intelligence behind the world.
That's the bit that people like. No one likes chaos. Everyone wants someone to be in charge.
Yes.
Even if it's an asshole.
Yes, we've said that.
But no, see, I... Because I'm a I'm an absolutist determinist, but...
You're a lot of things.
Yeah. Well, in as much as I want to kind of, like, sum up a personal philosophy in, like, really finite terms like that, but it's a bit like Mario Brothers, right? It's not okay. Real. I still jump the fucking Goomba. Like, it just because on a greater concept, like, you know, choice is an illusion, that doesn't mean I just go, I don't know what I'm having for breakfast. No, I'm having fucking eggs because I feel like eggs. The game is played that way.
That is sort of the root of the problems non-gamers have with gaming. They go, oh, it's a land of make-believe. But then no one does things constructive 24 hours a day, do they?
Good God, no. I try, and it's fucking hard. I
play video games, I read books. And I challenge people to explain to me how playing a video game is a bigger waste of your time than reading Harry Potter.
Well, they're fictional engagements. It depends on the book. Like, I'm reading through Feynman's physics lectures at the moment, and I think that's valuable because now I really want to do a second, like, degree after I finish my first one for, like...
Yeah, stay in that comforting academic bubble.
Oh, yeah. I'll finally emerge into the real world at, like, when I'm 50.
You go nowhere, cunt.
I'm thinking of doing it part-time because they actually really encourage, like, you doing sort of more things that allow you to be a more versatile teacher.
Yeah, nobody cares.
Up yours. It's a good thing.
Well, I don't. I speak for the audience. See, this is what I've noticed. I have to sort of rein you in when you waffle too much.
It's literally just us pointing microphones at each other. I don't just like the point of it's waffling. If you want, I'll just be quiet for half an hour. We can hit a thing with a stick.
Well, we have topics to prevent waffle.
But that kind of waffle, we kind of waffle between.
Let's not waffle about waffle now.
I'm going to make an excellent teacher. I can literally waffle about anything.
Now, give us another topic.
Pillow castle.
Oh, yes, you showed me a video of this.
Yeah.
Just before we started.
I'm so,
this
a
was
cool...
a CES thing, wasn't it?
I think so, yeah. I don't know, I just, someone linked it and I was like, oh, look at that. And then I just watched it and by the end of it, I'm like, ah, oh, that's really amazing.
Yes, if you're not familiar with it, it's a conceptual game thing which demonstrates false perspective gameplay in which you can change the size and nature of objects by moving them around with fixed perspective. So you can move something closer to you and it becomes smaller. Like, you grab the Statue of Liberty in the distance, and then, like, move the camera down a bit, and then place it in the floor in front of you, and it's actually very small.
You're on YouTube. Just type it into another tab now and look at it.
Yeah, I'm not describing it terribly well.
Yahtzee's not really selling it exactly. Like, it's... By the end, I think it's like a 7-minute long video. By the end of it, when they're sort of getting into the cleverer kind of gameplay puzzle designs, you really get a sense of just how nifty a game they could make off of this, and it's really fucking cool. I was really excited by it.
Yes, I remember you being quite excited, but my point was, it's kind of a one game concept, isn't it?
Well, yeah, so was Portal.
Yeah, but the thing that made Portal good was the stuff around it.
Oh yeah, they had a good...
There was a game that had Portal's technology. It was like Narbacular Drop before Portal, but Portal put it on the map, and it did it outside of the gameplay with, you know, mimetic humor. And my point is that the game, like the game technology advancements and proofs and concepts that excite me, are the ones that will sort of imbue a new sense of invention into all gaming, not just like single concept gimmicks.
Well,
so that's me being a downer again, because it's how I get off.
Just masturbating to World Vision ads. Crying children. It's always got to be crying children.
Yes, but they have to be black crying children. That's the important thing to me.
Yeah. You can only come in the face of absolute privilege.
It's a racist fantasy.
It involves race. It's not racist.
I mean, don't get me wrong. It might make for an interesting game.
I really think it's something I'd never have thought of, so I'm just impressed by it.
Even in the video itself, though, it's kind of demonstrating how easily it is to cheat these things. I mean, it seems like one single item could be all you need to get across any obstacle.
I think that's where the cleverness, like, that's, you know, in terms of making an actual game about it, then you're going to need to get some clever puzzle designers.
It is tailor-made for crate stacking puzzles, which is kind of the default.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's obviously going to be a big part of it, but by the end of it, when they were doing, like, going through doors and coming out smaller or larger in order to get a different perspective, like...
That was pretty cute.
Yeah, like, come on, that's clever.
But then the game literally was sort of being Portal at that point, wasn't it? You can sort of imagine a feature like that being in a Portal sequel.
Well, I mean, what are the odds that, you know, Valve will just buy it and integrate it into the sort of weird little collective world that Half-Life and Portal...
It's possible, if they can stop making bloody Dota 2 all the time. Which I don't give a shit about.
On an objective level, you're allowed to enjoy whatever you like. I'm glad you have MOBAs, like the little battle games and whatever. I'm glad you enjoy them. I'm glad that there's money in them and that people can have fun.
Just enjoy them somewhere far away from me.
Personally, fuck your stupid fucking MOBA games. I fucking hate them. I don't ever want to hear about them. And it infuriates me that those are huge popular money spinners when good games aren't.
Yeah. That's us being snobs. We can't help it.
That's, you know, there's a difference between objective and personal feeling. And objectively, you can enjoy it, and I don't care. Personally, fuck you.
Okay. I don't know
what did that do? Magic came out of that.
I don't know. What the fuck is this?
Shouldn't you know? Like, this was...
I don't know. I haven't been playing with this mod for long.
So there's just loads of weird shit that it does.
I just wanted to get back into vanilla Minecraft. That's all I've been doing.
Then suddenly there's all of this.
That was all this shit. Not saying I don't appreciate the jetpack and scuba gear, but I didn't build them. Someone just gave me them.
Some kind of wizard.
I mean, how do you build a jetpack? Let me look this up. Not a jetpack.
Jetty pack.
Right. So, here's what you need.
Fucking hell.
You need a glass fiber cable. You need an engine booster. You make an engine booster from... You know, that's the only thing in this thing I know how to get. And you need to go on a nether venture to get that. Advanced... What the fuck?
I patted myself on the back when I managed to make a fucking mallet once. I was like, I figured out mallet.
I made a lever once. I made a lever that made a shower work.
Okay, so, and the next, like, sort of YouTube thing we looked at today was Get Even. Which, yes, is where we get to be also giant game snobs again and just go, so fucking what?
And I'm still not entirely clear what the point of that video was. It seemed to be just going, graphics, and then sort of jazz hands.
Graphics, jazz hands.
Graphics, thank you. Thank you for your time, viewer.
Because
what was it? It seemed like this thing, what it was seemed to be showing, was that some engine that scans an environment and then turns it into a game, is that it?
Well, that's the thing. Like, the video itself doesn't make sense without an explanation, which I don't think
And viewer, watch the video so you know what we're talking about.
Yeah, well, I mean, again, like, I'm...
I'll be here carving these rocks.
I am merely parroting the explanation that was given to me. All right. So, essentially,
go on, then.
The way I understand it is... This company has, like, the Better Reality, I think the name of them, or whatever it is, has a thing where they can kind of scan an actual environment. This isn't, like, something done on the fly. Like, it's like they'll scan an environment a bit like how they did the faces in, oh, God damn it, what was that Rockstar 20s?
L.A. Noir.
L.A. Noir, yeah. A bit like how they did the faces in L.A. Noir.
40s.
Yeah, 40s.
Not and 20s.
I get it ass backwards sometimes. Ugh. It's post-war, gotta remember that.
Well, that doesn't help.
Oh, yeah. Post-depression. And then that allows them to, like, make, like, kind of hyper-real locations and what have you. And, you know, they use that to make burnt-out concrete.
another ruined, sodding building.
Ruined urban environment.
Because we've got such a massive shortage of those in video gaming.
I mean, it's not to say that, like... Because, you know, the jump from 2D to 3D created new gameplay. It created new gameplay options, and...
Yes, but it's been a long time since there's been a paradigm shift of that importance.
Yeah, like, that's the thing, is graphics can really add to gameplay. By themselves, they do not. So, and again, like, this was, like, I've always
been in a position that graphics are about as realistic as they'll ever need to be. I mean, we played Just Cause 2, it looked fine.
We say that now, but I mean, I remember being impressed by Dreamcast graphics when I was young. So I don't know. Maybe we'll look back and be like, "Oh, look at this shit."
Well, you know, the graphics hadn't reached that line yet.
Yeah,
Where at a point the human eye just doesn't pick up on any higher resolution, or any higher number of colors.
I'd prefer it to get to the point where making those graphics, there's like tools to make those graphics easily. So, you know, gaming could be opened up to more creators without. Because it's a hard thing to do. Like, even just looking at your stuff on Game Maker, yeah. I just look at these big walls of, like, numbers and shit, and I'm like, I can't do that. So that's,
you are a tard.
Yeah. I'm, exactly the kind of Laputan.
The Laputan machine. Yeah.
Head in the clouds, practically useless.
Yes, that's why you're stuck in academia, isn't it?
I don't know, I wouldn't exactly call, like, you know... If I was...
See, I never got a college education. And look at me now, motherfucker.
Yeah, that... So, all you kids trying to make millions on asinine, unoriginal YouTube videos, or...
Keep dreaming.
Diving into a field that is... You broke your thing.
Man, I'm using up a lot of pickaxes on this venture.
Can you make an indestructible pickaxe? Like, you should be able to.
Well, if I had diamond, yes, but that's kind of a tall order. And it's not strictly steal indestructible.
Dude, we should
last a hell of a long time.
No. Okay, so we're on a shared server that friends of mine use. We need to go and blow the house up. No, fuck this.
Dude,
fuck your arboretum.
Dude. If I did that, someone's going to blow up my house.
How would they know it was you?
This is an eminently blow-upable house.
How would they know it's you?
I don't know. Probably because they know I'm recording this with you today.
They won't know. They'll never watch it. They'll never find out. They'll never know. This will be brilliant.
How will they ever find out? I mean, we're only recording this and putting it on YouTube.
No one will know that me and you, Gabriel and Yahtzee Croshaw, blew up the house.
I'll tell you what what we could do is go on a sort of thieving expedition.
Yeah, like, let's go steal some of the diamond.
We're alone on the server now.
It's Saturday. They'll all be, like, getting ready for work because they work in bars and shit.
It is nighttime, though, so we'll wait till it's day, though.
We speed that up and let's go to bed. I want to go wreck someone else's stuff.
Well, fuck off. I want to build
I'm
going to
download Minecraft and get on this server later and just ruin things.
Well, now you've just revealed your motivation.
Yeah, I'm not ashamed
I don't want
of
you
that.
Ruining my biodome complex.
Oh, yeah,
fuck
I could
off.
Come back here and, like, wreck your biodome.
If you did that, I'll kill you.
I won't. I'll just, I don't know, draw dicks on the wall somehow.
Don't draw dicks on my biodome complex, but...
That leads us into Yahtzee's choice of fluffy topic, which was best games that let you draw cocks on things.
Yes. 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 I think this is an underappreciated subgenre of all management and survival and basically all kinds of gameplay. Is that
I kind of feel sorry that the vagina is not as eminently drawable as the penis.
Well, you know,
like you kind of have to look at a vagina drawing for a second to get what it is. Like cock, it's like
draw a sort of Sheila Nagig or something. Like draw a pear that's been cut in half.
Split pomegranate. But, I don't know.
What are our favorite games that allow you to draw cocks?
I feel that I've not spent as much time doing this as you have.
Well, I feel, you know, every game to a certain extent lets you draw cocks. I mean...
Mario Brothers.
You can draw... Yeah, exactly. You can just be very, very careful, and if you find a big patch of coins, you can draw a cock with the coins left behind. And if you're very, very... And if you use, like your pistol in Half-Life... You can make a cock out of bullet holes on a wall. It's a wonderful new expression of schoolyard exercise book defacement.
I
think it just shows how secure gamers are in their sexuality.
That's one interpretation.
Well, of course, the reason why I bring this up is because when I did my original review of Minecraft, I made a joke about making giant golden cocks in Minecraft. Because that's something you can do.
People make functioning calculators. They make full-scale replicas of the Enterprise.
But more importantly, they draw cocks.
Cocks.
And I bring this up because I got like 50 people. Still, I think people send me pictures of their giant golden Minecraft cocks.
I do love that. Like every one of these, or you know, every couple of these, like we'll just accidentally mention you looking like something, and then you'll immediately tell YouTube not to draw it, which is hilarious. I love telling the internet not to do something.
Yes, I think I've learned my lesson now.
No, you'll forget. That's the thing. We all forget. You'll make some utterance at some point, and then someone will, you know, draw you as something else. I'm not going to suggest something because I don't want to bait this too much. I want it to be organic and natural.
Well, now I'll stop specifically telling them not to do it. I'll say things like, please do send me pictures of your giant golden cocks.
There's no way to win. It's the internet. We'll
have a little montage of them.
It was when I used to, like, back when Mana first opened, and I'd take suggestions for the costume I'd wear on the door. And all I'd get is naked or Chun-Li. And
of course you did, man. Yeah, that's what happened.
No, and this is one of my... I never really interacted with, you know, the wider sort of random internet people. So I was unfamiliar with this, and then it's like...
He's talking about it like you're that fucking Gorillas in the Mist lady.
Well, to be honest, there's a fucking similarity. Like,
never before interacted with the internet people in such a way. But you know, I looked into their big brown eyes, and I think we had an understanding.
I wouldn't go that far. I don't think we have an understanding yet. I understand not to interact with them on certain levels.
Yeah, you know. That's all you can do, really.
Yeah, just... It's its own ecosystem. I don't want to fuck with it.
Just don't interfere with their delicate ecosystems.
Yeah. But yeah, and then I said, okay, how about we do... And it was like, you know, months later, and I'm like, all right, how about another idea, this time not involving Naked or Chun-Li, and then, of course, it's just Naked and Chun-Li again.
Yep. Or people would say not offer any suggestions, but just sort of discuss nakedness and Chun-Li in general.
Naked Chun-Li. Naked Blanca was an interesting one.
You know, I once posted this on Twitter, but I think it applies to all the internet. Like... Posting anything on the internet is like posing a question to a crowd, and then everyone puts their hand up and goes, I don't know!
Yeah, I do love that, like, when you ask them for an answer and someone just sticks their hand up and goes, oh, me. It's like, huh? Why did you say anything? Why did you do a thing? Like, just...
I mean, that was a joke in Blackadder, like the first series, where he asks a question to, like, a mob of villagers who've just burnt, like, someone they're trying to get hold of. And says, what happened here? And like one of the peasants raises a hand and goes, I don't know. Another one goes, no, me neither. I was on the other side of town when we burned her.
Yeah, that's people. And I don't mean people as in every individual. I mean people when individuals collected to that mass. Like the mass that we kind of, you know, name people.
Ah, fuck people.
It's just, it's weird, like, the kind of weird little behaviours you get when everyone collects into sort of one horde is... It's interesting. Mm. It's a fascinating little...
Have I done this wrong?
I don't know. I don't know how you do it right.
I'm just trying to create a vaguely circular chamber.
That's... Thumbs up! Yeah, it looks good to me.
But this doesn't look right.
Hey, here's another topic. Oculus Rift.
Oh, yes. You know, that is something I'm looking forward to.
Yeah, because the new thing was at CES, and apparently it's like the new, I can't remember what it's called, Crystal Caves or some shit. What did you just do? Did you eat?
I just sort of rubbed a steak on my face for a while, and now I'm not hungry anymore.
My 27th birthday, I want to say, I came back to the bar, like this is one of my first bars I worked at ages ago, like after I'd knocked off at like midnight.
You said knocked off.
That's what it's called. You knock off, you finish. And I was fucking poleaxed, like I was hammered. And I've come back with a full New York slice pizza because in my hammered state, I'm like, I'll get pizza for everybody and it'll be like a like kind of, you know, a hobbit birthday where I get gifts for people. And that's a nice thing to do because I want to be nice. And I came back and nobody wanted this fucking pizza. And I find all this out kind of...
Something's gone wrong here. I'm not sure what.
I don't know. And I find all this out kind of in retrospect because my memory kind of clicks back and people telling me shit that I've done. So I vaguely remember buying the pizza and coming back to the bar with the intent of sharing it with people. The thing is, I just woke up smelling like pizza. And then gradually other people tell me, yeah, you came back with this. All right, rain's turned off.
Apparently it was raining. I have no interest in your surface business.
I am the underlord. And I was trying to eat a New York slice pizza and was failing and was just... kind of rubbing it on my face in the hopes that I'd get it in the right hole.
That's more like it.
Yeah, I got to see the security camera footage of that, actually. That was adorable. You know, that kind of level, you know how like...
Doors of perception?
No, like that kind of level when someone is like a special needs kid or like one of the Down syndrome guys. So they automatically fall into that social category where you give them more allowances and you treat them a little gentler because, you know, they're not fucking mentally right. And there's a certain level of drunk where people just fit into that as well. Like, they're just... You're so drunk, it's like you're kind of like the retarded kid now. Just
humor them. Yeah, give them some space.
Just humor them and, yeah, you have a good night, buddy, and stuff like that.
You ironically refer to them as Professor Gabriel.
he's dead. You don't get to see him anymore. He died. I regenerated. Drunk Gabe is going to be like the fucking John Hurt of my life, where just no one... People forget about him, you know? Yes. I have people that I've met, like, after I quit drinking, I was like, I'd like to see you drunk. And it's like, why? It's not like I've... You know, this is a big flash, and suddenly I'm some fucking, you know, interesting
Maybe
thing.
Maybe because you used to be fun.
Yahtzee, Croshaw, Enabler.
And you didn't waffle so much with a sense of just aloof superiority.
Yeah, I did. If anything, I was worse. Because at least, like, I eventually get to a point. So, like, sober, I get to a fucking point. Just loop back around.
Imagine that, internet. He used to be worse.
Yeah, fuck yeah, absolutely worse. Well, this is, again, it's like, I don't talk like this when I'm having a conversation. This is a performative act.
Oh, yes, you do.
No, we don't.
Remember when we used to chat in front of the bar while you were working? That's why I wanted to start recording our conversations, because I felt we had a sexy chemistry. Now we're going on a cow...
Is this making music?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
We're going on a cow hunt.
I maintain we should find one of our friends' houses and mess with it. Like, maybe not, like, break it, but just, like, put a block of dicks out front or, you know, make a dick block.
Well, I suppose I do have to make a run to some other area to dump some shit into a lava flow.
Do it.
Because that's the only way to get rid of all this stuff you mine out that you don't have a use for.
So a bin doesn't exist? Like, someone hasn't created, like, a bin?
Not really. Well, you can stick stuff in chests, but then it just takes up space in the chest.
Who's Madame Deathstrike? Do I know them? Because I know a bunch of people on the server, because it's a bunch of servers.
I'm not even entirely sure who is behind these names. They'll probably let me know next time I see them in person.
Open up a chat.
No.
Yeah, this is fun. Talk to them.
I question your interpretation of fun. Ooh. See, this is another person's area. They built a giant causeway over the sea.
Blow it up.
What is your obsession with destroying in this game of construction and creativity? All you want to do is break down what others have built.
Yes.
What's wrong with you?
I wish to vex and annoy my friends. It's...
And you wonder why you have so few friends.
I don't leave the house. I have loads of friends, I just don't see them. Kind of deliberately, really.
No, they choose not to see you, because you want to annoy and vex them. You see it all coming together now.
Oh, wow, look, this goes everywhere. Fuck, this is long. Yep. I thought it just stopped once it got to the top.
No, this is going to take a while.
I still reckon you should wreck this.
I'm just looking for some lava. I know there's some around.
Being in, like, a sky... I don't know, maybe lava look, happens in the air?
Look, there's some.
Oh. I'll take that back, then. That's a good way of looking for lava.
Yes, there's another like, a growth of it at the end of the causeway, but...
Can't you make... Nothing. Can you make... I suppose you can't make lava, but can you bring lava back and have lava in your house so you don't have to do this every time you want to throw something out?
Yeah, you can use a bucket, but... Yeah. Actually, that's a thought. I mean, if I took the lava there, that lava would all go away because it's all spawning from one spot. Uh-huh. But if I can find a source of lava, like a lava bed, I can like get some of it in my bucket and then we can have our own lava disposal unit.
So if you have like, if you find a lava spawn block, you can carry the lava spawn block?
Yes.
Okay. Alright, cool.
And I think I remember seeing a lava bed. I'm just going to pop home and pick up my jetpack there.
Should've
because that's a useful thing to have.
Yeah. Yeah. It is a big, like, how big are the fucking Minecraft worlds?
Fucking insanely big. On my left, you can see a nether portal that the person who runs the area has built.
And that takes you to, like, the fighty areas.
Yes, the black portal takes you to the nether.
Yeah.
I had to make a nether expedition earlier.
What for?
Because nether is one of the few places you can get glowstone. And okay. Glowstone is one of the few light sources that works underwater.
I'm going to come back here later and burn their crops.
Don't burn, you destroying man.
You
just can't bear anyone else having something that gives them joy, can you? Because your heart is so empty and flinty.
That's not true.
Ah, I'm in the wall.
What's going on? Why are you hurting? I don't understand.
I don't know, something's gone wrong.
This hurts my brain to look at.
I don't know.
Fix it.
I don't know.
Fix it.
Happened.
Fix it. Fix it. Now I'm in the ground.
What the fuck?
Oh, there we go. All right. Well, we're out now.
Stupid portal. Apparently, portals in this mod are an inexact science at best.
Cobblestone.
Well, let's just keep that hole there in case that happens again. Now, where's my jetpack? I don't know what it is about Minecraft that makes me put on a West Country accent.
This reminds me, I've been trying... my dad's looking into getting like a basic PC now, because he has a tablet, and that's astonishing to him, because that's basically Star Trek-level technology, and he can like just look at videos and shit, and he loves that. It's amazing to him.
Yeah,
which,
it's crazy.
Yeah, like that's like literally when he was a kid, that was fucking science fiction, and now he's holding it, which... gives me hope that one day I'll have a sex robot, but
why do you want a sex robot? Wouldn't you feel empty?
Probably. That's just a facetious joke. Like I would probably be scared of it, to be honest.
But it would be all coming over to you saying, "Would you like to put your penis in my mechanical were-vagina?"
Were-vagina.
It is my purpose. Do not deny me my purpose, master.
Eggs validate. But I really want to get Dad into EVE Online.
Why would you want to do such a heinous thing to an innocent man?
Oh, look, there's somebody.
Hello.
Talk to them.
Don't mind me.
Fucking say... Tool. I'm in your house. Fucking hell.
Yeah, they got busy.
That's insane.
Well, I think they had an automatic digging robot.
Here's a little bit of why I want to...
Just making sure I'm still wearing that jetpack for a jump off.
Destroy and wreck people's stuff is because this is a weird amount of effort to put into something.
Don't destroy and wreck.
Like, it's odd. Well, not like major destroy. I mean, odds are I'll just come in and like make a penis out of blocks and then write Gabe was here, haha, and then leave. Like, that's probably the extent to what I'll do it.
That's your creativity, is it?
Well, again, I need purpose, and messing with someone is enough purpose. I can't, like, I don't see the point in building something in this. I can't.
Where's all the lava?
Do you suppose this was all lava once, and they sort of flushed it away?
I remember there being some around here.
What's that?
I don't know. Must be something from the mod.
It's a machine. Many machines from Ix.
Oh, that might be a... What the hell? Might be a pump.
Yeah. I want someone to make Minecraft RNA. I want to see someone try and get... There's probably a really good reason why that won't work, but I want to see someone try and make, like, just Minecraft start evolving on its own. Talk to them. At least ask who this is, because I'm fucking curious.
Do you know where I
can there's some lava
find
to your left.
Some lava?
Look, lava!
Can I
borrow a cup of lava?
Can I borrow a cup of your lava? Cheers. Ears.
Who are you? I'll find out later.
Let's keep it a mystery.
Yeah.
Now, where to put my fancy new lava?
Was that like a spawn lava? Was that... Oh, okay, cool. So now you'll have lava, and now you'll have a bin. Imagine if that was how you had to have bins in real life, like fucking...
Well, it's a pretty economical bin, having some molten lava.
Would that work for just trash in general? Like, there's probably a reason why it won't work. Like, physics always has this thing where it's like, no, it won't work.
I think we need to build a garbage chute.
Yeah, with lava just goes straight down. Where's it go? I don't know, but it's hot.
So we'll keep that for now, and I'll... Where should we connect our garbage chute?
Here's another fun little YouTube thing that I looked at recently. Alien Isolation. And you hear, Yahtzee, there was a trailer of not completed game footage for a new Alien game.
Oh, where have we heard that before?
I know! I sarcastically put a tweet up of, like, final game footage, and it was just an image from the SNES version of Alien 3.
See, it's hard to separate the utilitarian portion of my utopian place. I think I'll just make it part of the bedroom complex. Put a little garbage chute in the corner here.
It'll also keep your bedroom warm. So
yeah,
it's like,
there you go. Oh, it makes sense.
But this Alien game is going to be... apparently there's going to be only one xenomorph, and it's going to be like a horror game, so you got to hide from the thing and avoid it.
Well, that's kind of cool, I guess.
It's a tough... One of the biggest problems with...
it's very easy to talk a big game,
yeah,
isn't it?
Well, yeah. One of the biggest problems with Colonial Marines for me was the way they conceptualized the xenomorph, and... they made them kind of like your standard first-person shooter enemies that can take a bunch of hits, walk away, come back. And they should have been like the zombies in Left 4 Dead, where they don't take a lot to go down, there's just a fuckload of them.
Right.
And that's... because that's, you know, if you look at Aliens, like, which is essentially what the game's really based on, that's the fucking sum of it. Like, if you put an alien and a Colonial Marine with a fucking, you know, rifle... in a big white room, the alien's screwed. Like, it just gets shot and it dies. What they have is numbers and sneakiness and being hidden. And they should have, like, imagine, like, Colonial Marines, but, like, or maybe, there probably is a fucking mod of Left 4 Dead that has them replaced by the Xenomorphs, actually. I should probably look that up.
I think that's just Aliens Colonial Marines, isn't it? Except they add a plot as well.
Well, no, because the time we played it, and it was like, you shoot the aliens a bunch, and they don't register having been shot. Like, they're just a block that you have to pour damage into until it hits
a
certain point.
It was weird. I remember it was really obnoxious that the animation frames kept jumping about. So at any time, you could be shooting at thin air or a limb.
Yeah, God, that game was awful.
It was.
It and Resident Evil 6 are just the worst games I have played in...
By the way, that was another housewarming gift. I think that might be what our friend we saw earlier used to make their big pit.
Go have a look at it. See what it does.
It's an automatic coal-powered excavator. I use it all the time. We don't need it right now.
I want to see it work.
Wait, why is this lava source instead of the bucket?
Just
did it melt the bucket?
Are you holding it? Is that okay? It looks like it. You seem fine.
Wait. No, it can't be, because I put the bucket in the other chest downstairs.
Just get it downstairs and get it to its hole.
Now I'm confused.
Hold it in your hands, I'm sure it'll be fine.
I'm just looking for some stone tiles, I'm sure I had some.
I think Spore's probably the best game to make dicks in, because then the dicks are alive.
Yes, and they wobble about in the...
they wobble and...
procedurally generated animations.
And the head of it can have a big eye, because eye of penis.
I'm quite fond of making cocks in SimCity.
This?
Because that's not just a cock. That's a cock someone has to live with.
And live in a live penis.
Live in and see every day.
And live in a penis.
And you can just picture the people who deliberately chose to live there just because it was a penis. But then it's like 6 months down the line and the joke's worn thin even for them.
Novelty of this is worn off. You make a lot of cocks in a lot of games.
Well, I think it's a sort of universal language. Do you ever read...
I don't do that.
Hmm?
I don't really do that.
There's a sequel to... Do you ever read John Dies at the End?
No, although that is on the list. I'm in the middle of reading a shitload of, like, classic literature at the moment and modernist stuff, so...
I read the sequel to John Dies at the End, which is called This Book is Full of Spiders. Seriously, dude, don't touch it. Like, that's the whole title.
Yeah, I believe you.
And one of the major plot points... is that the main characters have to convince, like, a passing bomber that they're not zombies and that they're actually human. And they do that by arranging themselves into the shape of a cock.
Nah. Fair enough.
Because, you know, zombies wouldn't do that.
It'd be kind of funny if you could. Is that going to fill the area up with lava, or will it just sit down there?
No, it can't pour upwards.
I thought it might fill, like, expand and then just... I mean, not poor, but, you know, like, you know what I mean. Can't have the ladder to the lava. The kids could fall in.
Yeah, and I kind of...
Throw something down there. Test it out.
Well, I kind of want the ladder back.
Well, you can't. Apparently not.
Well, the so lava much for got that. It.
How are you going to get out of here now?
I'll just use my jetpack.
Oh, you're still wearing the fly thing, oh, of course.
And then now we have our garbage chute. And we'll just toss some cobblestone out. Bye-bye, cobblestone. Bye-bye forever. Bye-bye, more cobblestone. And more cobblestone. And so, more cobblestone.
Yeah. I'm guessing
more
you get
cobblestone.
A fair bit of that. Sand.
Yeah, some sand for good measure.
Sand.
Sand. Man, this is therapeutic. Fuck you, dirt. Filling everything up.
I know why we humans can't have a hole straight to lava in their house, but God, that'd be fun. Because, I mean, we'd all, you know, half of us would be dead, and I'd probably be amongst that. Like, I mean, you play the exciting game of pushy-shovesy near the lava hole, and then suddenly you don't have a little brother anymore.
Can't pollute lava.
Yeah, I'm more curious about that now. Like, can we really just dump shit infinitely into lava? Like, I'm sure there's a good reason why we can't, and
why
it'll
not?
Cool.
I mean,
and
maybe if we dumped shit into the sun, that would extend its lifespan for
The problem that Dad explained to me was, like, why don't we just put shit into a rocket and shoot it up, is, like, rockets explode sometimes.
And also, and
if there's something radioactive in the rocket when it explodes, that's probably not good.
That would take a significant amount of resources.
Yeah, like,
we just had some kind of teleporter. We could teleport things to the sun. Then that
I think by
fine.
The time we've got teleporters, we will have resolved, one way or another, we've probably resolved the garbage issue already.
Well, there's so many things you could do with garbage once you've got a teleporter.
I think once you've got a teleporter, garbage, like matter, ceases to be just, you know, it's not garbage anymore. You can just rewrite it. You could just teleport it, and at the end, now it's a sandwich. You know?
That's not teleportation, though. That's transmogrification.
Well, yeah, but if you can break matter down to its component parts and rebuild it in another location... in total, that's, you know, you could just rewrite it. You just decide that it's something different when it gets to the other end, I presume. I don't know.
Well,
apparently they managed to teleport a photon, and I have no idea really how they did that beyond that basic bit of information.
Well, we've dug it out. Now the problem is...
that's really your arboretum?
Well, not yet, obviously.
Okay.
I just need to build the glass ceiling so that no women can ever work here. Just a question of how I'm going to do that.
Ladders. Okay, maybe if you get the scuba gear on and go up and come down from the top. Because if you dig out a little area...
What I'll do is I'll get myself at the exact dead center. And then we'll use mathematics, like a smarty architect.
And you can just punch a hole and put a ladder there. And that way you'll have like a guide hole.
Just remember how many squares across this is.
You won't have to do that if you just
one,
put a hole there.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 6, 9, 10, 11.
Just dig up. Yeah, see, if you dig up and put a ladder there, you'll be able to see from the top.
Do, 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 do.
Magic ladders, they stop water.
What were we talking about?
We were making fun of another alien game.
I bet we were at that.
Yeah.
Right, there's where all the water is.
And we should. I mean, conceptually, again, I mean, this is kind of why getting just Jack of the Hype Machine a little. Like, I like it, you know, sometimes it's fun, and sometimes it's fun to engage in it, but everything does it, and...
Yeah, fuck that hype.
It becomes exhaustive, and it's kind of hard to enjoy a thing when, you know, you got that fucking just wall of hype going, hey, 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 look, isn't this fun? Yeah, 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 extreme! And it's just...
Yeah, 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 you say.
Hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know what I mean, it's just... It exhausts
a little. Oh, no, I don't know where the fuck I am.
I mean, you try to avoid it specifically. You grumble at me if I mention anything about a video game.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I try to avoid any mention of a game before I have a chance to play it. Because that's the only point where your view has any validity.
I don't know. I mean, it's kind of like in history, like a bias is not bad if you're aware of it.
Well, is it though? Is it?
Well,
that's all I got. Do we have any more topics, or shall we go kill cows?
You repeat a persuasive point, Yahtzee. I don't know, how long have we been recording?
Oh, a while.
Alrighty, we're just past the hour, and the recorder's still going, because I made Yahtzee put new batteries in.
Oh, is it past the hour?
Yeah,
oh.
Well, just.
Oh, how time has flown. What fun we've
had. For you.
What fun we've had building my biodome complex.
I think, yeah, you've enjoyed this.
I certainly did.
Here comes water.
Yeah, and there it goes again.
Magic. I kind of like that, like the weird slow motion splash it does.
Mm.
Can you have like just a water feature, maybe just like the water comes down, or would it fill up? Like, would it flood the area?
No. Well, if you put like guards around it, then it would.
Get rid of the ladder for a sec. I just want to see the water stream in just for fun.
Well, if I just
make
like
a visually interesting thing occur, please,
Mr. Fusspot.
You didn't need to do two. Yeah, just. Ooh, look at that.
See, it spreads out a lot, but if you put like a block around it,
then so will it not expand beyond those?
Yeah, I mean, if you just like, I think if you just have a stone slab there, and there, see, that will block it.
So it won't fill the area like it would.
No, if you surrounded it, that it would all stop right there. Water doesn't really have like
water
a fixed
properties.
Volume in Minecraft. It just keeps going until it stops.
That's a shame. I kind of wish it'd just keep. Like, I wish you'd be drowning now. Like, that'd be kind of cool.
Oh, thank you.
Well, not, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Gabriel wishes that I would drown. And I think all the viewers are having similar feelings. So perhaps we should just say, have a lovely time with your own Minecraft project.
This has been Yahtzee and Gabe's Minecraft Hour.
In an English country garden.
You know, enjoy your crafting.